You can go down there. You can go down there. It's, yeah, it's... Come on down to 1903 Wyandotte, the Keyhole Gallery. Host of the first Friday Mardi Gras Extravaganza. Kansas City. Don't forget. Oh.
Where do you keep your phone? Where it's safe. I guess if the music stops, that means the phone is gone.
Yeah, we just set it up. I'm a little bit tied up.
Sorry to unplug you. Just one plug.
Hey, that's
actually, I might be able to get an adapter plug for the mic a little better.
Oh, okay. That's awesome. That's in the spirit. It's fabulous.
Right. because they need, and they could collaborate, and they could be around other artists. I mean, that's important, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
And we would work on, like, one street at a time, or however many, 52 houses, like, blocks, that are all very close together. In fact, every house is close together.
Right.
And there's a raffle for who gets the houses, because there's only 52.
Right.
Start with.
Right.
We're going to call this...
Jeff is talking some important stuff here. Jessica, if I can select the camera. In the lower corner is talking about a photo, art. Somewhere. There it is.
So it enables you can plug the elements in. I mean, you can go all the way down to
stay away from food. Where? Where, Tima?
So it's a really awesome program. It's super user friendly. It's as sophisticated as
Tima. Hey.
But CAD is a really high level program that you use for architectural design. But it, this is just
it's used to adapt when the when food is around. Tima. Yeah.
Oh, it's okay.
Stop going after food, huh?
Oh, excellent. No, that's awesome. Yeah, no, that's awesome.
Do you like that? Yeah, can I write that? Well, no, she told me you were free on Friday. But she may have put something in the
We're pretty flexible, and I have a lot of time. I'm in a position where
I can switch it back to the Jeff camera. There it is. We hear everything they say. Evil plans are being hatched at the front door.
Oh, absolutely. I would love to be. I mean, I've got some experience doing it just independently, like on my own. Like, we went and bought a house in the Northeast, and we did it as a partnership, and the idea was that it would be an example of what can be done. Like, we're buying vacant lots as we can, because they're about $500 each. And I mean, so it's cheaper than buying agricultural land. I mean, right on the verge. It's like, so that's who I'm going for. Yeah. No, I tell you.
Okay, my husband was in the city. He's being very vague about it today because I had him on the phone earlier. And he was saying it's really difficult to get the land on there. What is it?
Oh, no. It's not. I mean, but here's the thing. This, you like, okay, so there's an office in the city. You go to the Jackson County, you get a list of their 2,600 properties on it. It's tremendous. Yeah, I mean, and so there's just a huge number of properties. They're going for about $500 an acre lot. And so, I mean, you can get a quarter acre lot for $500. I mean, so, you know, an acre's looking at about $2,000 for some really great land for agricultural use. I mean, as a derivative use, which I'm seeking to do. I mean, I want to do the whole neighborhood. We're within the zoning restriction, so we have 100 feet from our coop, which is what's required. So we're okay. I mean, we're right at. Oh really? Okay, I thought it was 100. So that's awesome because I have like 101, you know, from the garage. That's
right, exactly. And they have a standalone garage that's 75 feet.
I know.
Stupid standalone garage that they never use.
I think that what I've discovered, I have a miniature rooster. Which is
a
bantam, a chavo of Japanese.
Okay, wow.
Super small, and he cock-a-doodle-doos in the morning and stuff. And my neighbors like him. They really like him. Now I had a friend who brought a full-size rooster to the city.
It's
too loud for the only. A lot of people liked him. There was a person who worked at night and came home in the morning, and so he would go to sleep at 4:30, and it would be just really loud. Ours are very social. We have coffee with them in the morning. They'll sit on our lap.
I mean,
they're
completely. Like
they're really like
you need to pick up your chicken every now and then, put their feet, make sure they
don't
have to
go. No, I carry them around. And, I mean, we're but I raise them by hand.
Yes,
you know, so
but they are sweet. They come like dogs. They come like any animal. Uh-huh. Just spend any time with
that's
them.
Right. That's right. So my neighborhood really likes it. Like, I've had people drive up. My situation that really turned me off for the whole thing was dealing with dark, and I mean, that was a real nightmare scenario. We were thrown in jail. I mean, it was a bad scene. I was strip searched. I mean, it was treated like I was a drug dealer. I mean, it was, it's really crazy. I am the